Doma Sports Talk, worldwide, with some news from the world of boxing. So y'all know what time it is. You ain't in a rush to get concussed. Now, over the weekend, we had a few fights, and one I didn't even watch. You know, I get around to it when I get around to it, because it was Amir Khan versus Samuel Vargas, and I kind of knew that would probably be one-way traffic. It's the second fight after a while off with Amir Khan. So I didn't feel like it was one of my priorities, and I told you guys I haven't been feeling well, so I'll get around to it. But that's not really the point. Khan wins the fight, but he was a bit knocked down, but he won the fight pretty much every round is what I'm hearing, and that's what Khan going to do to a Samuel Vargas, which is pretty good. Now, the bad, right? You know, Khan Frotch, you know, former world champion, one of England's baddest ever, right? You know, was just saying, during the fight and after the fight, I watched one of his interviews with IFL TV. He said, you know, just Khan was a mediocre performance, right? And some people got irked by that. Maybe they think it was a great performance. But winning every round probably is a little bit above mediocre, right? I can agree with that, right? But he says it's a mediocre performance. And he also just states, well, do you think that this will be a fight that's good enough for him to fight the major players? Right, I'm paraphrasing here, in the welterweight division, you know. So that's one thing, and I just don't think he's you know, he just says that he's not a cheerleader. You know, he's not going to just sit here and be a cheerleader. He says Khan is back because he wants to just, you know, make some money, and that's what it is. You know, that's why he's talking about Manny Pacquiao after that fight. You know, because listen, guys, there's Errol Spence, right? You could say that name. You can go get him. It don't seem like he wants him. Or you could say Danny Garcia, the guy who knocked you out already. You know, Danny Garcia just lost to Sean Porter. You can get him. Not really interested, right? And the main one is Kell Brook, right? That's the it's still a huge fight in England. And you're lucky that it is, because neither one of them are the best in any division that they are. But because they're in England, they can probably fill a stadium, which I've been saying for over a year. They can fill, they can probably both lose another fight and still fill a stadium in England. Because I told you, anybody fill a stadium in England. I told you, and I'm going to keep saying it, if it irks you or not. But Nigel Benn Sr. and Chris Eubank Jr., Sr. could fight and fill a stadium in England. Right? There's just not that many sports and competitions from other sports. So boxing has a higher level of exposure in that country. So that's cool, though. There's nothing wrong with that. But, you know, as a fan, you have to be a little bit harder on these guys. You can't just say, hey, everybody's our gods. Make them earn that god status, right? I don't think nobody should be upset at Khan Frotch for just giving an honest opinion of what Khan is up to now, because he just wants to fight Pacquiao, and Kell Brook is right there, right? And, you know, we've seen how he's treated Kell Brook over the years, right? He just seems to just don't want to give him that fight. Right now, Kell Brook has to come down to 147 to fight him back at 147. That's what Khan's fighting. Well, all you got Khan fans, you know that Khan had to strip down to nothing just to make 147 himself. So he's having problems himself making 147. So he must make Kell Brook go to 147 because he thinks Kell Brook won't. And when Kell Brook says, yes, he will still come down, but only for you, then he changes the goalpost again and says something like, I just want Pacquiao. So that would irk people. The same people that would irk people that are similar to the people how Anthony Joshua is treating Deontay Wilder. You know, people who don't want to fight, if it's Khan or Joshua, would still be named first. You know, like Joshua's name is in front of Deontay Wilder's, not in my book. Or Amir Khan's name is in front of Kell Brook, not in my book. The guy who wants to fight, their name goes first. And that would be forever. Lennox Lewis' name is in front of Mike Tyson's, in front of Holyfield, and definitely in front of Riddick Bowles. Forever. I don't even like when I hear those names before them. Because the guy who wants to fight and the guy who doesn't want to fight, the one who doesn't want to fight name is always behind the one who wanted to fight. That's just a simple way. So I just think Amir Khan, he could do handle his business, but, you know, if you can't get Manny Pacquiao out, there's that Kell Brook fight. And I think he should be able to take it. I don't think that why should Khan Frotch get so much, you know, flack for just giving his honest opinion about Amir Khan. Let's see what happens going forward. But it's the same thing I told you. Amir Khan, Adrian Broner, Tyson Fury, Lots of times I might say whatever, you know, because it's a little bit of delusion going on with these guys, right? And, you know, Amir Khan's a decent fighter, but he has lost a few times. And, you know, you want to get, if you want to get back to world level, excuse me, world level, then you're probably going to have to fight a top class, world class fighter. And then it starts with wanting to fight a world class fighter. And right now, Manny Pacquiao used to be one. And he seems to only be focused on that. And England, you're depriving them of the fight that England still considers to be big. A lot of other people don't. But Kell Brook versus Amir Khan carries a lot of weight in England if it continues to happen now. Now, Eddie Hearn, who promotes both of these guys, has said if that fight's not next for Kell Brook, he's probably never going to happen because Kell Brook has a hard time making 147. So let's see what happens. I don't think Carl Froch should have got any flack whatsoever for giving his honest opinion. He said he's not a cheerleader, right? And that's what we have to do when it comes to these fighters. We're not cheerleaders, right? That's why when I'm talking to Anthony Joshua, Canelo, Golovkin, guys that I'm on right now, but right now maybe Amir Khan, that, you know, some things you don't like, the way they're trying to treat other people, right? I wouldn't argue with a woman who likes Anthony Joshua or Amir Khan. Or a gay person, right? Because, you know, there's some other things going on there. So I'm not going to argue with them. But a guy, a man, full of testosterone, I would argue with him, right? Because something was probably wrong with him. But I don't know if there are many of those left fans of those guys. Because it's just too many glaring things that they've done. So let's just see what happens going forward with Amir Khan. I hope he fights Kell Brook. I hope Pacquiao finds somebody else to fight. So Amir Khan is forced to fight Kell Brook. So England can finally get that fight that they so dearly want. And, you know, at this point, I think they deserve it. While these guys are still at least a little bit relevant. Because Kell Brook is going to have some problems at 154 as soon as he steps up and fights the main guys there. And Khan is going to definitely have some problems as soon as he steps up and fight the main guys in 147. So let these guys fight. And then England has a big, big, big dust up. And they can have fill a stadium. Wouldn't that be nice? Let's see what happens, guys. Domus Sports Talk, worldwide. And I'm about here, y'all.